Hey, it is Kelsey, and today we're going to be going over how to overcome your biggest fears, worries, and frustrations about going to the gym. Now, before we do that, I want to go through a couple of comments that you guys left me on my last video about mean comments that I've gotten about my body. She said, "Gross. You're disgusting." Similar to yuck, she seems to find me unacceptable. It's always so amazing to hear your feedback, and I love being able to communicate with you through comments. I'm just gonna read a couple of those before we get into today's video. So Brooklyn said, "I love and adore you. Thank you for inspiring me to be better and love the healthy body that I was blessed with." I love that so much, Brooklyn. Keep it up. And then Elena said, "You're inspirational and look amazing. Thank you for sharing these tips. Social media makes it easy to compare ourselves to others, which can be so toxic." Yeah, Elena, I totally understand that. And that's why I think it's so important to do what we're doing here, to call those things out, to be able to have conversation around it so that we can not only have more confidence in ourselves, but be able to really move through these things and make everything better because of it. The other day I posted a sticker to Instagram asking my followers to give me some things that were their biggest fears, their frustrations, their worries about going to the gym. And it was very interesting because there were a few common themes that a bunch of people said. So I'm gonna read through some of the different themes that I heard about. First one was feeling self-conscious about my body. A lot of people said not knowing what to do, not having correct form, fear of getting injured, fear of comparison, judgment from those who have more experience than them, waiting for equipment that is taken, men who tell you what you should or shouldn't be doing or staring at you. This one I thought was very interesting because these two came right in a row. One fear was, "I'm too big to go, I'll be judged." The second one was, "I'm worried about becoming too big." So I fear, another one was germs and lying in other people's sweat. So there are lots of common fears about going to the gym, and I wanna help give you some tips so that you can overcome those fears, feel incredibly confident going into the gym, be able to get in your best shape ever. Okay, so the first thing that you can do when you're going to the gym is have a plan. A lot of times people go to the gym without really understanding what they want to be doing, what they want to be working on, and so then they get there, there are so many options, and it's like, where do you start? So if you have a plan and you have a general outline of what you're gonna be doing, that really alleviates some of that stress, some of that decision fatigue, and you can really be able to get in a great workout. Now, leading into another fear and frustration about going to the gym is, what if the equipment that I want to be using is taken? Or what if I have to wait for it? So if you have a plan, you can have a general understanding of the things that you want to be working on. But if that type of equipment is taken, for example, if you plan on doing barbell back squats, but the squat rack is taken, what do you do? There's some very simple things. So you could go and do dumbbell front squats. You could do dumbbell goblet squats. You could do so many different things that are very similar types of movements to get in that type of workout if the rack is taken. So having some different modifications and different variations that you can do can be really helpful so that you can still get in a great workout, do the workout that you planned, but use different and alternate equipment. Another common fear is about form. People not feeling like they understand how to do certain movements, or they fear getting injured if they do try certain things. Now, something that can be really helpful is to just get a couple of sessions with a personal trainer and work on some of the basic movements, especially if you're new to weightlifting. Learn how to do a squat, learn how to do a deadlift, a push-up, pull-up form. These are all great movements that if you get a few basic tips, you can really be practicing them, feel confident in your form, and make progress in those movements. If you're worried about germs and sweat, just simply wipe off the machine before you get going. A lot of women express feeling intimidated going into the weight section because it's maybe mostly men or maybe mostly fitness professionals. Now, the only way to get more women in the weight room is for women to go into the weight room. And I know that that can feel a little bit intimidating, but if you take that first step, if you are that leader, other people will follow. You will encourage others to take that step to start building strength. Another easy thing too, bring a friend. If you feel like uncomfortable being the only woman in there, bring your girlfriend with you and dominate it together. A lot of women express that they feel really uncomfortable when men stare at them at the gym. And this is something that really needs to be worked on in general, but something that you can do. If you feel awkward if someone's staring at you, stare right back at them, right into their eyes. It's going to be super awkward for a second, but then maybe that will click in his head, "Oh, that's kind of rude, I probably shouldn't be doing that." And if he continues to do it, if he's just being a creep, go up to him and say, "Hey, you need to stop staring at me, that's not okay." And if you don't feel comfortable doing that, go and talk to a manager, a trainer at the gym, someone else who is an authority who could help do that for you. Fear of judgment is a huge one that so many people said. So if you feel this way, you are not alone. But here's the thing, if you are going to the gym, you need to realize that most people are really fixated on what they are doing and they're not super concerned with other people's workouts. And if they are, if someone is by chance judging you and the things that you're doing because you chose to go to the gym and improve yourself, that is their problem. And you honestly don't want to be their friend anyway. Because honestly, who cares what Brock from Planet Fitness thinks? Comparison is also a huge fear going to the gym. Now here's the thing, you've probably heard this saying before that you cannot compare your chapter 1 to someone else's chapter 20. It's just a completely different journey, and so if you evaluate your progress based on someone else's progress, it's not fair to you. So this is you versus you, and when you evaluate your progress versus your day 1 versus your day 30 and so on, you're going to be so much happier because you're going to see, wow, that's where I started, and that's where I am today, and that deserves to be celebrated. Body image. This is a huge fear and concern for people going to the gym. Like I mentioned earlier, one person said that they felt they were too big to even step foot in the gym. Another person said they feared becoming too big if they went to the gym. I just want you to know that if you feel that way, you are not alone. So many people experience this, but there are some very simple things that you can do to combat this mentality. When you make the choice to go to the gym, you're making a choice to improve yourself. Regardless of your current body size or whatever your goal may be, feel confident in the fact that you are taking a step to improve yourself, and it's a journey. Again, this is you versus you and not you versus anyone else. So when you step foot into the gym, be confident in who you are. So those are a bunch of common fears that my followers express that they are feeling. So leave me a comment below. Let me know, what are your fears? What are the things that you are working through in your fitness journey? Because I promise you that you are not alone, but these are all things. When you speak them out loud, you can work on them and overcome them. You are worth it. Nothing and no one can stop you. So go to the gym, get in those workouts, build your confidence, build your strength, and become 1% better than you were yesterday.